So today we start our lectures. Good evening, everyone. I hope that you receive your mark for the Baptist week, and you already have the feedback. And some of the students raise an issue that the feedback with the question number is not matching the question with the solution. Unfortunately, I have see the questions for multiple choice at the beginning. Other students see the multiple choice at the end. You see short answer in the middle. Some students, they have short answer at the beginning. So it's completely random. So it's customized in such a way that each student has his own version. Even the choices inside the multiple choice question, you might see, the same multiple choice question. Even that, we have like 10 choices. Part of these choices, but we make sure the correct one is selected. So I don't know, I told you in the beginning, don't look at your neighbor, even in the lab test too. So make sure that focus on the answering the questions. We start reminding you today by lab test two. Please mark it in your calendars. And it's worth 50%. What is included? It's mainly chapter number 3, chapter number 4. Regular expression and pattern matches is not included in the lab test 2. It will be included on the lab test 3. Now, in addition to these topics, you have static and non-static classes, constructors, and class methods. These are part of the lab test 2. It's not direct. We focus mainly on chapter 2. But you cannot skip creating a class, because you cannot create a method inside Java without creating a class. So you have to make sure that you have looked at the chapter number 3 and V3, L3, V4, L4, and patterning and pattern matching and regular expression are not included in the lab. The exam, again, it's November 8th for the morning session. We're going to start at 10, so please be there on time. And we're going to end also at 12. So if you came late, let's say due to some reason, you are at 10:15, you lose 15 minutes. So you make sure, plan ahead of time, stay safe. Got flu or headaches or something like that. I will make sure that whenever you miss a lab test, I just want to let you know, you have 48 hours to inform the instructor. If you didn't inform the instructor within 48 hours with a medical reason, a valid medical reason, you're not eligible to have the test. So you might say, I don't have access to, I cannot see you or something. No, you have access to the email. this lecture part of it in the last question. Anything related to the strength is included in the last question. Anything related to the regular expression is not included. Okay? Any other questions? Okay? Last time we covered exceptions, array, characters, and we go to the string, but we didn't complete the string. Today we're gonna try to complete the string and go to the regular expressions. We discussed last time the character, and we say the character is one of the primitive data type of Java. So it's not an object type, so it's a primitive data type, and it can be defined as char, given name of the parameter. One code, single code, indicate this is a single character. Okay? Now, we discussed last time that Java understands the character char as Unicode, or some people ask code, which is that to translate the character to be stored in one byte. So 8-bit will be used to store the value of the character. So we are capable of seeing the character, computer see the character as an integer, positive integer value that's stored in 8-bit, 1 byte. So being able to do that, so we can have some method to check if the character is digits. If the character is a letters, that's moved from A to Z, capital or small. And if the character is letter or digits, so we are saying that we need to make sure the character is sign or a space or character change, which you can do line, is lower, upper, and also is a white space. We can make sure that this character is a white space or not a white space. And to lower, we can convert the character from uppercase to lowercase, and also from lowercase to uppercase. Now, we discussed that the character is a primitive data type, so we are eligible and we can use equal, greater than, less than, not equal with the character, as you can see in the slide. A small is less than B small. Why we can do that? Because this is a primitive data type, it's not an object type. And also that Java understands the character A small as a positive integer. So the value of A small is a positive integer, is less than the value of B small as a positive integer. And also we can print the character using for loop. So you can initiate the for loop as char C is equal to A small, get small, and then is less than from Z small, and you increment C++. And C in this case is a char type, it's not an integer type. But again, this back to the Java, where Java understands the char as a positive integer. So we can increment the char vector, and in this case we print all the characters, the lowercase characters, as you can see on this slide, from A small up to Z small. This all about the characters. We discussed it all last time. Now we start the string. String is not a new topic for you. Since we start this course, we are handling the string, because apps that you develop using Android Studio, whenever you talk to the user, you will enter everything as a string. Then inside the model class, you transfer this string to integer, to doubles, and also you do the processing in the model, and you generate, let's say, a double data type. You need to send it back to the view. You need to transfer this double to string, because the view always input and output from the view on the app is a string. So a string is not a new for you, but let us dig deep and see what is actually Java expert offer us about string. And there is a lot of features and methods that we can use in a string to manipulate and extract some useful information from a string. Now, a string second line is the standard way to create an object of type. Any question? By coding .NET, and also we can retrieve the value at any particular location by calling the string.character at, and we give the index of that character. This is integer. Now, let's say this string is a capital dot space BCDEF. This is a very simple string to create. So it will be stored in the memory from index 0 up to index 7. And you notice here that space is a character. So we have a store space as a character. So when you calculate the length of the string, do not ignore the space. The space is a character. Will be stored in one part. Any question? Yes. Yes, the length of the string is 8, but the number of index always starts from 0 up to the 8 minus 1, which is 7 in this case. Okay? Now, to create the string, as you can see on this slide, we have a string 1 and string 2. We create them. Again, I don't need you to put s small. S is capital because the string is an object type. So I saw that on the lab test 1, students, they still have s small. String is s is capital. So you create a string. You can use the shorthand creation. So in this case, we have string 1 and string 2. What do you think we should get? Two strings. That means we're going to go to the memory and have some space here for a string 1 and some space here for a string 2. What's the value for a string 1? Hello. But the value for a string 2? Hello. But Java is very smart enough. It will say, okay, I already have created a memory where the value of that string is hello and assign it to string 1. Now, the user or the client or the programmer is asked me to create another string called the string 2. And what's the status of it? It's hello. So why should I waste the memory? Java is trying to optimize the memory. It will assign to the same string. So this is very important. You have to be careful. And there is a lot of discussion about this issue in 2030. But now, the only thing I need you to know that the Java is smart enough to handle this issue. So don't think that S1 and S2, string 1 and string 2, are actually referring to two different locations in the memory. They are referring to the same location in the memory. Java will understand that this string, the status of this string, is the same as the string 2. So it assigns it like this. Okay? If this is a problem, how we can solve it? We can solve it by using a new string, by using the new keyword. So by doing this, we say, I need S1 to be a new string, and we give the value, hello, or Java is 1. And S2 has the same state as S1. That's why we can call a copy constructor. So a copy constructor will take the object and create a new object with the same state. That is the copy constructor is doing. And exactly what we're doing here. We use string and we give S1 as an argument. So we're going to create two independent strings. Both have the same state, but referring to two different locations. Any question? That would be next slide. Good. So in this case, we have to be careful on how we handle the string. Again, string is an object at a time is created by Java Expert. So if you do like this, you end up with the same reference. If you do like this, you end up with two independent references. So you as a programmer, determine your requirement. I don't want to generalize it, or I don't want to make it, I make it more specific for a strength. This is for a strength, okay? For other objects, you try and see. Normally, if you need to do a cookie thing, you have to provide a cookie constructor in your class. And there is more discussion in 2030 in advance about clone methods, that is cloning the object, and cookie constructor, all of this will be not part of it. Now, to check for equality, because a string is not a primitive type, you cannot use equal or not equal or a greater than or less than. So we have to be careful. For equality, we have to use equals method. We have to provide the regular method that makes sense about the content of the string. So equal, it's wrong. It will only give me an indication if two strings are referring to the same place on the memory. If that is the case, I will receive true. Otherwise, I will receive false. So whenever you need to handle a comparison between the string, avoid using equal. I'm not saying it's a compile error. No, the compiler will go with you, but you end up with wrong result. That is not meaning that S1 is equal plus 2, okay? To be able to compare the string, we have to use equal. So S1 dot equals S2. So by doing this, Java Expert create equals method for us. Look at the content of S1, look at the content of S2, and tell us if these content are the same or not. So, as you can see here, we have created a new phrase, name1 and name2. And we ask name1 dot equals name2. What do you think the result will be? What will be printed out? Based on this discussion, what do you think the output? The strings are not equal? The strings are equal. Okay, that is the output. Remember, the output when you print it to the screen, there is no double quotation. Okay, don't give me the answer on the exam with double quotation. Double quotation is inside to tell that this is a string object. That's why I put a double quotation on inside the compiler. I'm not a compiler. I need the answer. So the answer for the client will be without double quotation. That's correct. Because we're going to check about the state of the string and make sure if the two strings have the same content. Okay? Now, what do you think here? We change it. Not equal. Why not? There are two different locations in the memory, that's true, and they are referring to two different locations. You can have string is not. Even the content are the same, okay? And we avoid the Java intelligence because we are using a new string, okay? We are forcing the Java to create two different objects in the memory and use name1 as a reference and name2 as a reference, and both are referring to different locations of the memory. Yes, the content are the same, but they are referring to different locations. If you're not using the new, if you're using new, you force Java to create an all new object. Now, if I create them without new string, Java will be intelligent enough to know that these are the same, so we'll do that. Okay? Any other questions? Okay. Now, if we can make comparison between the string based on the value for quality to make sure that these strings are equal or not, why we cannot make the comparison between the strings and compare them so we know that this string is less than this string? Again, think about it. String is an object. Java Expert created for us. And they provide all the necessary tools for us. They provide an equals method that can check for equality. Also in case of we have S1, is it greater than S2, we're going to have positive value. What about 0? In that case, we have two string values. Okay? And there is more discussion about this in quality. Because quality and comparison between the string value. So you can, now I can say for the string, if the string are compared to return 0, that means they are equal, but is if in under the X state. Okay? So I'm not going to go deep on that, but I want you to make sure that comparison for equality, you have to call equals. You want to compare the strings based on the orders. You want to sort them out. When I say this string is lower than this string, you want to sort the strings. You could compare to. And this applies to any class that you create. For example, you create a PMI class on the app 1. Yes? You want to compare between the objects based on the PMI. So you create an equals class method and you create compare to. And you provide your own methodology to sort out the object. I create a class of a student. I want to say two students are equal if their name and ID, social insurance number, are the same. Yes? But if I want to compare two students, which one is the first, which one is the second, may I use compare to? I compare based on the GPA. So in this case, I compare between two students based on the GPA. So if the two students have the same GPA, I will have the result is equal to what? 0. But doesn't mean this are two students are the same. You understand that? So the comparison for equality is always different from compare to. That whenever you need to sort your objects, you go to compare to. You implement the method compare to if you create that class. Java Expert create a string for us. So they provide us with this methodology of comparing the string and order these strings based on that compare. The first thing is to look at the length. Of course, the shorter length is greater than the other one. And then element by element, they have the same. So A small is lower than B small. Okay? If A small, B, B small, straight element by element. Okay? But the first view, yes, the shorter length is what? Less than the longer. Okay? Now, after we compare the string for equality and order the string using compare to, we need a mechanism to search inside the string. So we have a string, and we can search inside it using index path. We can give a character and ask for index, and we can ask for another substring inside it. As you can see here, we have hello world string, and we would like to search for a position, the first position for H small. It happened to be at the location 0. Okay? Is the first occurrence. Index of will retain the first occurrence of a pattern. In this case, we are searching for a substring. In this case, a character. In this case, is what? A substring. It happened to be the substring because we have a double quote with the linked one. So the first O appeared on the this string, which is hello world, it will be at the location 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now ELL located at 1. The first appearance of this substring. So we have the mechanism to search inside the string. Character X is not appearing at all, we retain minus. First one, 0, 1, 2. Then if you want a second one, you have to cut the string and do the search for another one. Okay? not even asked to sit at the particular positions. So I want to start my sit at index number 5. So if I ask for O, starting from 5, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so I will start from here, it could be an allocation number 8. Okay? Don't forget the space. Okay? If I ask you to trace the execution of the program in the lab test 2, and most of the students are going to give me 7. Because they forget about the space and the comma. Comma is a character. You can observe one byte. You take one position. Space will take one position. Okay? Good? Don't forget that. There's a lot of methods, but I highlighted some of them in this slide. Index of, we saw that. Equal, ignore cases. This is very important. You check for equality, and you want to ignore the uppercase and lowercase. So I want to make sure the string are the same. Sometimes we, some students, they like Toronto with the capital, the small, but my interest is Toronto. The same thing I did in your lab test 1. So some of the students, they like 3x. I want to say, okay, it's supposed to be x small, but I want to be lenient with you. So if the students like 3x capital or 3x small, I consider that a true. Even for some students with s is small on the string, I consider that a true. Okay? Now, start with, if the string starts with some index, substring, and end with, you have a substring, it's end with some substring. Replace, you have a character and you want to replace it with other characters. You want to frame the string, remove from the beginning and the end white spaces, or you want to make it lowercase, or if you want to make it uppercase. All of these, you see here, retain an object of type string. We cannot change the current state of the string. We can only create a new string and retain it back. If you would like to go through the string value, because it's a sequence of characters, you do the for loop as you're doing for arrays. You start index I is equal to 0 up to I less than the string dot length. Okay? You see here, length, and you have the parentheses here. If you are using array, you don't need the parentheses. And then you have I plus plus, and you can ask character at I. Okay, so in this case, you go for loop to do the processing for each string, for each character inside the string. As you can see from the for loop, it's the same as doing for loop for an array, of integers, of doubles, okay? So you are going through element by element and check the value of character at that. Any question? Now, you can see here, this is an example. We have two strings, S1 and S2. We ask to print the length and index of E. I would like to take, let's say, half a minute and give me the answer. Just to trace this one. This is part of, let's say, a practice for you. By the way, some students ask for how we can prepare for the lab test. You can prepare for the lab test by reading three things. The lectures material and see the example. Try to do these examples in the computers. Don't look at the solutions. Okay, even my slide that I bought in the Moodle without the solution, so I force you to write the code on the Android Studio and generate the results. And also you can read the textbook, the example on the textbook, the exercises at the each units and learning marks. Look at the exercises. Okay, they are not from other planet. They are from the textbook. Okay? And also the labs. What you did in the lab. If you are sitting idle and your friend is taking care of everything, that is a problem. Because in the lab test, you're going to do the program. Okay? So you have to make sure you have the knowledge, the theory, to answer the multiple choice questions or trace execution like what we see here, and also to be able to program. Okay? So, what is the output for the first one? 15. Then what is the index of E? The first occurrence. from 7, 8, 9. 10 is not included. Okay? The same thing. You can see here. I create a new string in S3. I take the substring from 2 to 8, where 8 is excluded up from 2 to 7. So it will be 15, 9, I, B, E. Because these are three characters, not four. 7, 8, 9. 10 is not included. 10 is not included. So we have this. Any question? Okay. Now, this is an exercise for you at home. You have a string book building apps using Java programming. How you extract Java out of this string? Give me, this would be a short answer question. Give me a sentence that extract the Java out of this string. Okay? Good? How you can extract the first word of any string? The short answer question. What do you think the output here? This is a, now, there's a lot of questions about, I told you at the beginning of the lab test, assume everything is ideal. What is important if the code is compiled, everything. So I ask you to give me the output of this fragment. Don't ask me if this code was inside the class or outside the class or we have to import something. I assume everything is perfect. Like what you have here. Everything is perfect. So this code, assume it's part of a perfect program. It's compiled free. And when you miss one, what's that? That's what I ask you to do. Don't start to put yourself in a situation you are an expert and now you want to judge the question in the lab test. The lab test is asking you, what is the output of this? Assume it on the part of don't tell me, oh, raise your hand, waste your time in the lab test too. Should this would be a static, so this is private, no, this is included, or this is not part of it? I cannot answer this question for you like that in the lab. What I can tell you, I already write that on the head of the note, in the blue, I could be written on. It's a perfect program. So please, focus. What's the output of this? What do you think the output? Capital, yeah? That's wrong. That means we're not aligned altogether. This is wrong. You cannot change the state of the string once you create it. Did we change the state of the string? No. This method will retain a string, but unfortunately you're not catching it. So the output would be the same thing. You cannot change the state of the string. Okay. What is the output of this one? Now we have a string retained and we catch it and we assign it to this string. So we can only this two above. Let me just go back. Above or to lower between an object of type string. So let's take the string as an input, create a new string inside the method and retain it back to you. Unfortunately here, I didn't catch it up. I don't want it. So I just changed the status of the string, but I don't assign it to anything. So the state of the string is the same as string. No change. Here, no. See the difference? The same string, I create a new one and give it, change the state of it. You think that I change the state of the string S. Actually, I create a new one and assign it. Okay? This statement is a create, the one on the right side, is creating a new string and assign it back to S. Okay? It's not changing the status What's the output? Okay. So I would like you to take 1 minute. I'm not wasting the time of the lecture, but I would like you really to feel this one. And imagine that you are on the lab test, and I give you this mystery meter and ask you, what is the routine? Or what is this method is doing? Give me a sentence, a statement. What is this method will do? Think about it. It uses index of some characters, index of stack compositions. So imagine you have some arbitrary string and you send it as an input. What would be the output? So just have a rough idea about what. That's right. So let's say I am ECS 1102 students, and I call this method now. Then I will extract the first letter from each word. So I use the white space, which is the space, as a separator. And the first thing, you see here, I start from this one, index position plus one. So as you can see, the first character from each one. Okay? What I'm trying to do here is an example from the textbook. So what I'm trying to do here, I have the string, I'm trying to do what? Count the number of keys in a particular string. See how I'm doing this. Here, I create a new string inside the for loop. You can see here, a new string inside the for loop. You see the for loop is going to all the positions of the strings, and I create a new string inside the loop. See, it's a new string, and always extract one character from that string, from position to position plus one, and check if that is equal to E, and then I increment the counter. Now, the same for loop, I do it the same thing here. I calculate the number of keys, but look how it's more using the for loop and the index of E as an increment for the positions. You can see here, int E is equal to index of E, the first occurrence of E. Then, as long as the position is not equal to minus one, I will keep doing the for loop, and the next location of P would be the next location of the string. But inside the for loop, you see here what I'm doing? I'm creating a new string, substring, and assign it to the same string. So there is advantage and disadvantage of these two methods. So the disadvantage of this one is at the end of the execution, the original string is already str at the end of this. What is the result? I ask you in the lab test, what is the value of str after executing this? Okay, you see I change it inside, but here the value of str is unchanged. But both in theorem of, if the objective is counting number of E without the care of the input string, okay, both will count the number of E. Now, character versus integers. We said that Java understands the character as positive integers. So you see here, A capital is 65, A small a is 97. B capital is the next of it. So 65, 66, 67. What is 67 will Now, if I take the character A small, I add 10 to it. 10 is an integer. The Java will understand. Take the integer value of A small plus 10 will give me 107. Okay? And if I have, is that right? Yeah, it's right. A capital plus A capital will give me 132. Now, if I cast the result of addition, A small plus 2, and then cast it as a character, it will give me C small. If I didn't cast it, it's integer. Okay? Any question? If I ask you about it, I will give you a clue. Character is string. So double quotation is a string, single quotation is a character. Now you can have a character with one string with one character, or you can have string with many characters. So don't think that a string will be created if it's more than one character. No. In this case we have a string with only one character. As long as you put it inside the code, Java will understand it as an object or characters. Now, if this is correct, this is an error, because you have a char type and you ask to change the number, this is not part of the method of this and assign it to the char. You have to see the method in the previous slide, this is an error, you cannot do this. Now, what is S plus 1? What is C plus 1? You need to know the difference between this and this. This is a string concatenation. This is an integer addition. Okay? Because C is a char type, S is a string type. What is S plus S? This is a string concatenation. C plus C, this is a character addition. Okay? And we'll see in the previous slide. Now, part of the string is how to format the string. Sometimes you need to use percentage with B or percentage with F to format the string to print some value using a string to the user. So as you can see here, we have X and Y as an int value, and we use a string with format to format the string and print it to the user. So in this case, we have X is 3 as an integer, percentage of B, and also now, you can format use WD or minus WD or WR to make a space for the number that you need to print to the user on the string, either to right alignment or left alignment. So in this case, we are doing double for loops, and we are printing an integer value, formatting a string using integers, okay, and we print it to the user. Now you can see here, I would like to print a double, okay? I need 4 spaces, 2 of them will be for the decimal point. As you can see, the order of the printing is not organized. If I change this one, it's a matter of changing the number of reserved spaces for it. See, the more organized when I say I need 6 spaces, 2 of them for the decimal. Most of you are familiar with the string format because you use it a lot in previous time, just to make sure you cover it here. Now, okay, what about you can take minute like you to read this program and give me the output for what. Original